everyone, welcome back to VitoshAcademy. Today we'll be diving into Excel VBA to make your pivot tables way smarter. So imagine you have a pivot table with football stats and you want to filter it based on teams that have won the trophies in the last 11 years in England. So you would like to see these selections to filter another pivot table dynamically. And this would be something that would be done with VBA. So let's start. First, let's set up our data. I have prepared, as you see here already, some data set of English football teams and their trophies over the last 11 years from 2014 to 2024. And this is really simple. You have the team, you have the trophy, and you have the year, nothing else. And we'll be creating two pivot tables, pivot table 1 and pivot table 2. That should be really easy. So let's start creating the tables. First, we simply press somewhere in the pivot table and we press Control A. And what can we do? We go to Insert. And we do a pivot table from table range. In a new worksheet, we name it and we click OK. Now we have it like this. So pivot table 1 is the default name and we can set it up as follows. Let's first simply click everywhere and see what's going to happen. Okay. It gave us sum of a year, which is a bit not very useful, but it gave us some kind of a summary who won what. We see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 teams winning something in the last 11 years. And sum of year is a bit useless. So I'll change it to count just to see who won the most. Manchester City won the most trophies, obviously 17. We can sort them largest to smallest. Just to have an idea. Looks okay. Yeah, obviously we have one team winning everything, the others winning something. But that's not what we are going to do. Okay, we're gonna say rows would be team, columns would be trophy, and value would be count of year one, and we have something as interesting as that one. So yeah. Pretty much seeing Manchester United for Manchester City first, Manchester United winning two things. And if we click on it, we'll see that actually they won the FA Cup twice. And that's it. It's a detail. Let's delete back and let's go back to our table. I'm just going to rename this data in this pivot table 1. Like that. And this is the pivot table. We can actually play a bit with the ground totals, like remove them like this. And this way, you have to calculate yourself how many columns, how many trophies Manchester City has, and how many, for example, Leicester or United has. Doesn't matter. So pretty much this is our first pivot table, the summary. It's called pivot table 1. Great. And here we can select some of the things, but this is something that we will be doing later. So let's create a pivot table 2. So we go here, we press Control A, we press Insert, pivot table, new worksheet, and that's it. And this time it will be a bit different. Pivot table 2 is already its name. So in the rows, we will be having the team. Yeah. In the columns, we will be having year 1. And pretty much it's count of trophy. Yeah. Not that bad, actually. We see for each year who won how many. Yeah, we have one team, Manchester City, winning something 3 times. We can actually format a bit like this, so it's immediately visible when someone won something more than once. in a year, which is good. And now let's start adding slicers. So just to remind you, the idea of the video. The idea of the video is to find a VBA code that somehow gets the data from here, the one that we actually select, for example, writes down these three, Manchester City, Arsenal, and Manchester United, which is actually not that tough. But the tough part is once these are written, it will go into this pivot table here, and it would force the slicer, not the slicer, but the drop-down to select these cities, like Manchester City, Arsenal, and whatever the third one was. So that's pretty much the whole idea. So let's continue. We can add a slicer just because we can. Slicers are really, really fancy. It's really nice. Just go and say insert slicer, and we'll be adding a slicer for a team. And these are our slicers. And we can even name it slicer underscore team. This is the caption. This is not exactly the name. The name should be something else, but we would talk about it probably later. Yeah. The name is team, so we change it to slicer team. Caption and name of the slicer would be with the same name. And now we would be building a VBA to extract and filter. And I have built the simple VBA code for you. Actually, it's really, really simple. No error handling, but it works. So in order to test it, let's just remove Arsenal and Manchester United, as far as they didn't win the Premier League in the last 11 years. Manchester United. Okay. I'm clicking on control, but okay. Obviously, it should be the other way around. So I'm selecting Manchester City, Liverpool, Leicester, and Chelsea. These are the only clubs that won the Premier League in the last 11 years. And we want to make sure that we get these four teams listed here. This may sound really, really easy for you. I mean, if you are just first time looking at VBA, thinking that it's really kind of easy to go and take the data from a pivot table, but to be honest, it's not that easy. Although the code is here and you can take a look what we are doing. So I'll start with F8 step by step. We are setting the object cache, slicer cache. I mean, yeah. If you want to take a look what's in this object, you can go to Shift F2. That's a good one. Shift F9. Yes, Shift F9 is a quick watch. And if we click on the plus, we take a look at all the possible data that we can actually think about. Yeah, pivot tables, slicers, item one in the slicer. We get the caption somewhere here. And we even get the height and whether it's locked, its name, and plenty of other interesting things that we can use. Okay, so further we continue with F8, debugging step by step. So A is now 1 and B is now 1. We go to here and we delete anything that we have. For example, if we have this, delete it immediately. It would be deleted immediately after I press F8. And now we simply start looping through, and the selected values would appear in cell A, in column A, and the non-selected would be in column B. And I have even made an interior, so it's obvious. VB green for the selected and VB yellow for the non-selected ones. And as we go further, we see that Manchester United is too big. It goes in the next cell. So we are going to how to fit it. And so far, so good. This is what we have. Yes. So now we have this filtered manually by us. and we wrote the filtered data in a temp table. Yeah, not something fancy probably, but the fancy things comes now, if you are a VBA fan, otherwise this is not that fancy. What is the fancy thing? The fancy thing is that we're going to loop through these ones and select only these ones in the filter, in the second table. How are we going to do this? That's a great question. And the answer to this question is that we're going to use some other VBA code, including one old function that I wrote probably around, it's written like 6 years ago somewhere here, but it's actually way more. So let's run again our old filtering that actually writes here Chelsea, Leicester, Liverpool and Manchester City. And here our idea would be to filter this. I've written this code here. Let's compile. It compiles. Great. And let's start step by step explaining the code. So first we set a pivot table, which would be this one this time. Let me see whether I can increase it a bit. And like that. So we continue with F8. Then we set the selected range. And we can do a lot of things with this selected range. Just showing you here immediately in the immediate window. We can ask it questions and it would say Chelsea. The second value would be Leicester, the third one Liverpool, and the fourth one Manchester City. So next thing would be to clear the filters. They were no filters, but if they were, they would have been cleared. Let's just do it again. And now the funny, interesting part comes. So for each part of the pivot items, it would start a check whether it is in the range, and the range is the one that was given, selected teams range, this one. And if the answer is true, I'll simply click Shift and F8, so I will not enter. If the answer is true, it will be in the range, but in this case it's not in the range because this time we're talking about Arsenal. And Arsenal is the yellow one. So in this case, Arsenal would be set to invisible, not visible. And the same should happen for the others. I'll simply click here on the stop and press F5. And this is how it works. So we filtered it based on the temp. There is a nice question, what will happen if we don't have anything? And the answer of this one is, that's why we have this kind of a counter here. So if we click F5, and we actually get here, we are raising an error because we only have Manchester United left, and it is going to be removed because it is not in the temp. Then we press F8 and we get this custom error, no value in the pivot. Yep, so far so good. Probably we can catch our own errors. It's not a bad thing, but this is something for later. So let's summarize what we did. We had a pivot table, a data from which we made a pivot table. This is our first one. We selected randomly three football clubs based on whether they won the Premier League in the last 11 years. So we selected Leicester, Manchester City, Liverpool and Chelsea. Let's select them. Chelsea, Leicester, Liverpool and Manchester City. Based on this selection somewhere, we have generated the data from here, or in this case from the slicer.
into column A. And based on the values on column A, we have managed to run another VBA code. I will not call it macro, that actually filters. This is the last thing, is actually the highlight of the video. And the whole reason I write this video, so it actually remains, because it's extreme nightmare to go and to click stuff when you actually can have a code working for you and doing it. So thank you for watching VitoshAcademy once more. Enjoy the rest of your day and take care of yourself. Bye bye.